Okay, welcome back to part two of lesson one of the Build Your Own E-commerce Website tutorial series. In the second part of this lesson, we're going to take a look at the general organization or the information architecture of the site. And for the purposes of this tutorial, I've divided that up into four large categories or components. That is sales, information, marketing, and user experience. So by far the most complex portion of the site is going to be the sales portion of our site. And the sales portion of the site first includes our products, and in particular our product definition. What are the elements of the product? What are the variations of the product? What are the different parts of the product that we're going to display in what context? It includes the product presentation. So in particular, we've got a featured product, as we saw on the front page, which has some information about it. We have featured product. We have a summary product information, so a customer can evaluate whether or not they're interested in that specific product. And then we have detailed product information. So we have this presentation method that or methods that we have to develop. We also have data entry. We'll be using the WordPress e-commerce plugin, and we'll be using native thesis functionality in order to display those products, and therefore we're going to use both of those components also for data entry. And then finally, we have the shopping cart. The shopping cart that we'll be using will have both a buy now feature so that a customer can select the button and go immediately to checkout, and we'll also have the ability to have a regular shopping cart functionality where they can add multiple products to the site to the their purchase and then purchase all of those things at the same time. The second big component here is the information component, and in the information component, we first have just sort of the general information content. That's like blog posts, promotional information, stuff that you have on posts or pages. We have the product related content, which is again information that is on posts or pages, but it's related specifically to the description of the product. We have administrative content, such as our facts, our policies, our support information, that sort of thing. And then we have the SEO component, which is the way in which we organize all of this information so that it can be easily indexed and found by search engines. And one of the things that we're going to be looking at here at the on this as we develop this site is how our site's organization affects SEO and how we will develop what Google calls semantic URLs. That is, URLs that tell a story that are easily understood by humans. So the next part of this is the marketing component. And the marketing component primarily has to do with email marketing. And in particular, the largest and most interesting part of this part of it is going to be the email capture. But along with email capture, we're going to be providing value in exchange for that email. So we'll have a variety of ways of offering free products in exchange for email capture. And you can see that in, as an example here with this example where we have download your free ebook. So we'll have an ebook in exchange, but we also have free downloads of chapters. So, for example, if they want to consider purchasing this book, if they give us their email and their first name, we will allow them to download the first chapter of this book and to review it to see if they're interested in it. Finally, we'll have email follow-ups. That is the regular routine email marketing that we'll do to these people who have signed up on our site. And then finally, we have the user experience. Now, the user experience starts off with navigation. Our navigation system has a variety of components to it. It first has the standard navigation bar at the top that you're no doubt familiar with. It also includes breadcrumbs trail so that as the customer is working their way through the site, they can see where they are and they can step back to an earlier place. It will also include this search function, which will give them a chance to look for specific information on your site. And then finally, it'll have this sort of rudimentary site map. This isn't an extensive site map. It doesn't include everything on the site, but it does pick up all of the major elements that a customer might want to look at when they're viewing the site. The next element of that is support. And again, we will be working on a variety of, we'll look at a variety of support elements to the site. One of the main things is just making sure that our support information is clearly available and easily found on the site. And so not only does it show up in the top level section of the navigation, but we also have very plain and open contact information associated with the site. It includes a section of user interaction, and that user interaction shows up primarily in this, in the form of user reviews. We're going to give our users the opportunity to offer reviews for specific products, and then we're going to display those reviews in a variety of places on the site. And then finally, we're going to talk about clarity. This is one of the most important things, I think, for website design, especially for e-commerce website design. It's absolutely essential that your visitor knows exactly where they are, knows exactly where they can go, and knows where they want to go. And so we will be looking at those big things. Where am I? Where do I want to go? And what's preventing me from getting where I want to go. Okay, and that wraps up part two of this lesson. In part three of this lesson, we'll take an in-depth look at the sales component of this site.